All right, you're rolling, Broden.
Welcome to the Footy with Mates. This week, a very different... Make sure it's working, Tom.
Yeah, I'm just going to do a little bit of mixing as we go.
This week, a very special week with a very special guest. We're going to talk footy. But first, it's time to bounce that pill.
Yeah.
My man.
Welcome. Our next guest every member of King Gizzard and the Lizard Wizard were like, we'd love to come on. And then we were like, well, we're going to do music stuff, so it's going to be in a smaller room. So we got the best one.
My man.
You know him from King Gizzard. You know him from, if you're like us, you know him from Viewbank College.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's what I'm talking about.
Please welcome Joey Walker. Yeah, thank you.
Thanks, guys.
Audio might be scuffed.
Audio might be different, but because we're
flagging that?
Yeah.
Okay.
We're here. This is an episode with two audio files.
Yeah.
They're on a watch list for being audio files. Joe, thank you for coming in, mate. How are you?
I'm great. I'm feeling real pumped up. I listened to AC/DC on the way.
Really?
Yeah.
Which album?
Just all of it. Just top the top of the algorithm.
This is straight
up Thunderstruck.
This is AC/DC playlist?
Yeah, 100%. Yeah.
If you were to say who is the AFL as far as music, I think AC/DC would be number one.
Yeah. I mean, look, love AFL, obviously, but is that giving them too much credit?
Yeah. But yeah. if we put up a post today on Triple M social media.
Yeah, feed, you are right. You are right.
And said who should play the grand final this year?
Just flick that mic on, Brad.
Fuck! But is that okay?
Now it's off. Now it's off. You were right.
Oh, thank God.
You were good at all against
Gizz? No.
This is just the way we're going.
This is just how it is for this.
If you were to do that, the number one response would be Get Akka Dakka on there. Then number two, I would say, would be Foo Fighters.
Oh, the Fooies for sure. And then obviously Killers, but they've already done it.
Yes, Killers. Yes, but they should come back.
They should come back for sure.
Joe, but if you're asking anyone below the age of 35, do you know who I see come up regularly? Like, and I'm talking places like subreddits.
Yep.
I'm talking places like Instagram.
4chan.
4chan, the dark web. Yeah, do you know who's coming up as the people who they think should do the grand final?
Who's that?
Your rock and roll band.
Bullshit.
100%.
That's who we're big on, yeah.
In our audience, who is mammoth and could crumble empires?
Like, to be honest, like, it has, like, we've been, our name has been thrown around by the Affle to feature.
Really?
And do a Gizz at the G type thing. I'm not saying grand final, but maybe. But I think it's just like, with a lot of things like that, I feel like there's just so much potential for it to really just like...
We said this to Alex Leahy on this.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. It's like we could, you know, not saying that we think very highly of ourselves, but it's just like a lot can go wrong and a lot can like just fucking change in a bad way.
Yeah, yeah, guys don't ever sing live. You guys...
That's true as well. I could hit that,
Ashley Simpson.
The auto-T. Yeah, exactly. When Stu forgets to say his woo.
So if you were asked, and would you guys do it?
I would 100% dance with the devil, but none of the other cunts would.
Really?
No way. Like, and Stu would be the main kind of just like... No.
Not for me.
Yeah, not for me. Just, I mean, and I'd do it as a gag because it's like, ha ha ha, like, you know, this is going to be so shit, but... Also deep down, like...
Amazing. I have two questions. First, my pitch to you would be High Octane, Nonagon Infinity, balls to the wall. I reckon if you just did 15 minutes of that shit... Yeah,
I think it would land.
I think everyone would
I'd also be keen to just hit some covers.
Oh, yeah.
Everlong.
Yeah.
That could be sick.
Here's my third pitch.
Right.
Just do footy for 15 minutes and just rail off, like, 150 footballers.
That would be sick. And, yeah, I mean... What also would be good is if we did that and you were that narrator.
Well, I'm on board.
It would go for hours.
Yeah, think of the corporate.
Think of the stats.
Think of the room that we would have for the actual grand final.
Yeah, seriously.
Do you follow footy anymore?
I do. I follow footy. I'm not... I don't get as granular as you boys.
Yeah.
Mm. But I do...
That's a good word for us.
Yeah, you are granular.
That's interesting,
I watch footy... quite fervently. I am a newfound Carlton supporter.
What do you mean? Great. What do you mean newfound?
So I was a blue and through.
Right.
I was going to say blue and yellow. Blue and yellow West Coast Eagles supporter.
Oh, really?
So I was like, I was born in the Kimberley. Sorry, I was born in the NT, but we moved to the Kimberley when the Eagles won their first premierships in the 90s.
Yeah. Was that the reason?
And that was the reason why I went for them. But I was
let's move to the Kimberley.
Oh, no, that's the reason why. Yeah, yeah. Dad was like, we're going.
But the footy's not there.
Yeah,
but
the footy's not there, but we'll you know. And then, so I was like diehard Eagle supporter, and then we moved to Melbourne in the late 90s. I was still, you know, I was a member and like did all that shit.
Mm.
And I was kind of there for the West Coast Eagles era, like shattered when we lost the 2005 thing, and pumped when we won. But also, like, that was the kind of the flooding era of footy was just so
boring. Yeah, it did
so
get hard
boring.
To watch.
Yeah, totally.
But, and then I feel like once that kind of golden era of those, you know, those party boys, they left. I just kind of like, I lost the itch.
And then,
I was essentially a passenger. Yeah. I like didn't follow a team really. And I just kind of would just watch footy.
Yeah.
And get behind, you know, your doggies, get behind your underdogs. And then I essentially just, my dad goes for Carlton, started a family late last year. And I think we decided we're going to go for Carlton.
Yeah. They are. The team
it's a good time to go for it at the moment.
Yes,
well.
Yes. Particularly, there's multiple reasons, but they are a rising team.
Rising.
They are, like, where we're recording now is Carlton Rich.
In the area.
So that's, should we start there?
Yeah, we should.
We have prepared a couple of songs that we would like your musical input on.
Love it.
Which is, one of which is, should we just play it?
So you had it already lined up.
I had it lined up. I wanted to hear what a blues solo over this would be like.
Yeah.
I love the famous Professor Whiskers.
Yeah, of course.
Joe worked on a song with Auntie Donna once.
Yeah.
He got nominated for an ARIE. Did you know that?
That song did.
Yeah.
Love that.
The album did.
Oh, the album. Yeah. No, I knew that.
But
I knew
we
that.
Lost to,
and we lost, to, lost. We lost to one song.
Yeah. Which is a shame.
And they said they because have you ever lost an ARIA?
Many.
Yeah, I would have thought.
Did they send you a letter?
No, we didn't get any letters.
They sent us a letter just saying "suck shit, you dog cunt."
Yeah, awesome.
Which was rude.
Yeah.
It was rude.
So, what are we doing?
So we're gonna get Joe to play some guitar over the Carlton theme song. That's what I think we should do.
Well, can we listen through first?
Oh yeah, absolutely.
And give notes on why it's
there's,
bad.
There is kind. I mean, I'm happy to solo throughout the singing, but I feel like there's an instrumental break.
Yeah, there should be. There should be up here, right?
Yeah, you can.
But you could do a little.
Oh yeah, yeah. I can like call and response.
Yeah, that would be.
As a musician,
it's a bit jazzy. This one, I might fucking be fumbling around a bit. To be honest.
As a musician who goes for this team, how do you feel going for the team with maybe the worst song?
Are you kidding me? It's one of the greats.
This is...
It's a bit like, you know, it's like a fucking, like, Eastern European... Like, I mean, they actually all are quite Eastern European. Yeah. I love that Soviet shit.
To use King Gizzard as a reference point, right? In the period of Nonagon and in all that, is...
This
sketches, not this is not a good or bad. It's sketches of East Brunswick.
Yeah, yeah, true. Down, no, you are chill. Right. You are right. It's like, chill.
They beat Melbourne in the whatever it was to... I've removed it from my brain.
Yeah, that was a fucking semi or...
And then this song comes on?
Yeah, yeah.
It's not a brick wall song.
No,
it's not. It's sort of a lay back and feel the blues.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. Oh, exactly.
Yeah.
Shall we?
Yeah, please. You can plug into here.
Let's get a bit of rubiato going.
I'll have to stand up.
Yeah, this is a beautiful guitar.
Yeah, this is my flying V.
But Mighty Ducks reference, or?
I mean, maybe. Like, that's what man who started Marshall. Oh, wait, sorry, Gibson was thinking.
Yeah, I think
Horrible guitar to sit down and play, so I'm going to have to stand
which
up.
Which is great. As long as we keep you in the frame. There's a little something
we
for you there.
We can swap spots or something.
I remember you as an avid collector of guitars. You used to have several even when we were in high school.
I had Gas. But not anymore.
Yeah.
What's Gas?
Guitar acquisition syndrome.
Oh.
Yeah. It's applicable to gear.
Did you? How's my memory? Did you work in a music shop?
Yeah, I did a work experience at the now.
Fuck, do I remember that?
Yeah, how do you fucking that's
do it? I remember you saying you got a good deal on your red Fender. Yeah, I remember you got a good deal on.
Yeah, I like bought it off Jimi Hendrix himself and shit. Yeah, no, I did get a... I actually was like, the crew I bought it off were just like, I worked there, they were just like, we're like, don't buy this guitar, it's like piece of shit.
Yeah.
But I just like had me at Fender, and then they were just like, buy like this one. Anyway, so I got that, got stolen actually.
Did it really?
Yeah.
I had a few things stolen in my time as well.
I worked at a Hard Rock Cafe for my work experience.
Really?
Yeah, in the city. Now it's gone.
I was going to say, are they even a thing in Australia anymore?
No, there was, but they would give you, they paid me the bare minimum.
Mm.
And they...
is that where you cut your chops?
Yeah, and that's where I learned that I wanted to be a performer.
Yeah, I thought so.
They would give you a free lunch, but there was two options. There was a pasta and then nachos. So for 8 straight days I had nachos for lunch. It was pretty great, to be
honest. And that's as long as you worked there.
Yeah.
For once.
They didn't, I thought they might offer me
a know if I'm even in tune, but fuck it.
Fuck it. Are you coming through? What have I done? Have I done something wrong?
Is there I'll tap for tune. Let's do that. Oh, is there
anything? Hold for tune. Are you coming through?
Fuck, I'm gonna have to work this out.
Do we know what key it's in?
We have to listen. I think it's like the deceiving thing with these tracks is that they're like there's like many key changes.
Yeah, little complex.
Really? Passing chords.
Yeah, right.
But let's have a go.
Are you okay with the tone? That's a Kelly, Texas.
Yeah. Tex Kelly.
Tex Kelly.
Oh, that was groovy, Joe.
Thank you, boys.
Ready? I'll lead you in.
Okay. Wait. Flat. It's a classic. Yeah. Oh, it's in major.
Mm. I only know the minor because it's on the
nah.
Close, close.
Oh yeah.
Yes.
Yes. Brick wall.
You have to be some really 1940s style jazz musician to play that shit.
Yeah, really?
But what you had going on was very, very clever.
No, it's not very clever, but we'll have another
go. Same spot.
Would you want to go through from the start of the song and riff under it, or do you want to go from somewhere?
Let's do some call and response.
Carlton theme song with Joey Walker. We are the baby blues. We are the old dogs. Oh yeah.
Fifth, boys.
Yeah, you gotta careful with the fifth. You gotta be careful.
Oh, yeah, get some tap and go.
Yeah, hammer it.
That was very good.
Now, if they win the flag this year, which they very well could, I'm taking credit for it.
Fucking oath, boys. I reckon they're not going to win because of that, to be honest.
And that is the other side. If they do fall apart this year, I mean, they've already got some key injuries.
Yeah.
That's important to note that Silvani was injured before
recording of this, yes.
Yeah. All right, do we want another crack at that, or should we
No. Yeah, yeah, let's move on.
There's another one. There's a one that's more recently made.
You're going to fix that in post as well.
Oh, yeah. I've got heaps of abilities to do that.
Yeah, you can go back in, Tom, and just do it again.
Yeah, I'll overdub it.
Make it sound worse.
Yeah.
Detune of the...
And they're more recently by a member of the Cat Empire.
Yeah. This is that fucking Soviet shit.
Yeah.
The GWS Giants theme song. Mm. Shall we hear it through once?
Yeah. This will be easier. Pulp Fiction song.
Yeah. You were running that.
Oh, yeah, let's try it. Here we go, it's coming up. Shattering.
I thought that was excellent.
Just to check, you haven't done this on SEN or anything, have you?
I mean, that would be fresh, but no,
yeah,
I haven't.
No, because we've got the exclusive.
Yeah, we've got the exclusive.
Which is the one music that is that impressive, what he's done there to make a song that...
I think it's a really smart... When the team started and I knew that it was old mate from the Cat Empire...
Yeah.
His name?
Harry.
I thought it was a daunting thing to be like, all right, I'm going to fucking make a new AFL theme song.
Yeah.
And then most of the time it's going to be rubbish, but I feel like that really is a very smart and distilled version of what's great about him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you agree?
What's the time signature?
It's just 4/4.
Is it 4/4, but it's got a shuffle?
It's like kind of that country thing. And it's just got that I guess it's like that military
vibe. Russian.
Yeah, which I feel like is that thing. It's like a fucking call to arms. Am I right?
Yes, 100%.
Now you're going to love the third one we've got.
Yeah.
This is for you to riff off. I think you're going to dominate this one.
This is something,
it's a prehistoric now. It's dead. It's from a different time.
Yeah, yeah. This one goes for ages, which is good.
Yeah, I was thinking.
And it's already got guitar in there.
That's even got a solo in it.
You should have done Holy Grail as well.
Yeah.
And you're doing How to Make Gravy now.
Holy Grail at the same time.
This is the most Australian I've ever felt in my life.
Yeah, exactly.
That's a medley you could do. Your footy one for corporates.
Or the grand final.
Yeah, or the GF. Yeah.
It's neither of those, but it's in the right... Hit it.
Yeah. Okay, we...
Ty, there's an intro. I forgot, there's always an intro.
See, you work it out. I Google.
What do you mean?
I don't know. What key is
more than a... No, but you'd be able to work it out.
I would, but I just am so lazy.
Yeah.
And then I do the BPM too, then I put dubstep drums in.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. You know how it is.
Lander.
Yeah.
We call him Mr. Music over here, Tom.
Yeah. He does a fucking great job.
Yeah. No, I agree.
Yeah, this is it.
It's a fucking banger. I know the show is shit, but...
Okay, B flat again.
You know this song good?
Yeah. Understand, there's a fire that burns brightly inside you. Oh, wait, maybe. I need more juice, boys.
Absolutely.
Oh, maybe not. That's what's going to happen.
Because we're scuffed here.
much to do this freestyle stuff.
Yeah.
More than a game.
Oh, God. Yeah, I mean,
you need a mood shift, you just change the key.
I just have a, like, I honestly have a new found respect for the quality and the musicianship in AFL theme songs.
Really?
Except, I mean, I'm talking about the classics.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I feel like that whole era of songwriting from which the majority of them are from, they're in that vaudeville real.
Very much so. And it's even just think about it now, like an 80s team. Teams that started in the 80s, aka the Eagles, you'd fucking shred over that.
Yeah.
Well, let's, song. Can we try
pull
that?
It up?
Yeah, yeah, absolutely. Let's
Y2,
pull it up.
It's Y2, mate.
West Coast theme song. Is that what I write in?
Yeah.
When you're doing solos for your albums, is this how you go about it? I've seen, like, some people just sit in front of a loop and just riff over it.
100%. 100%. And it's like, even when I did that fucking Professor Whiskers or whatever, I, like, sent back to the thing, like, hey, here you go. But I was like, many loops, that note, like, and just like extraction,
yeah,
you know,
that's a good way to do it.
But do you have a favorite solo or like bit that you like to do when you're on tour?
I do. I mean, the latest record the heavy record we put out last year, the Petro Dragonic one, that was like the one, because usually we like toes the line of,
yeah,
you know, being quite cheesy at times, but I feel like we are very aware of that line.
Yes, yeah,
so
yeah,
we
yeah,
do
yeah,
pull back and like subvert. We try 100%. To release. But that record is like, fuck, let's just
go
flood
it,
the market.
Like just tapping it.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
The market.
So, and that's the other thing. It's like, all right, well, if I'm playing metal solos, like I'm, as you've seen today, I'm not very good.
I know.
That's also a giant, I'm a bit of an imposter, which I'm happy with.
I was going to say that.
Who cares about guitar heaps? I'm like, you're a fuckhead.
Yeah, no.
So it's all about just like, you know,
playing, you know, putting on the face. Yeah. You know, absolutely. We do that with comedy all the time.
You
just got to pretend that you belong there.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
How many songs, off the top of your head, do you think King Gizzard have?
I mean, we've got a list of, we've got like a spreadsheet of like the songs in the rotation of our live show,
yeah,
which is like upwards, I'd be over 100.
Yeah.
That we just kind of draw from.
But rotation on tour, you're ready to play 100 songs.
Yeah, it's incredible.
Yeah. I see if I can.
I was at the 3-hour special in Melbourne.
Oh, no, the one.
Where you tore down the tower.
Yeah, yeah.
Very special show.
That was special. That was our first dip. Like, that was our first, like, try at the marathon show.
Yeah.
And we were, like, so scared.
Yeah.
And now we've kind of got it a bit more dialed.
Yeah.
We used to, like, up until kind of recently, we would have a break, which we did not have. Mm-hmm. And then we've realized that that actually kind of deflates the whole thing.
Yeah, we find that with intervals too.
Yeah, with comedy, it does it too.
Like, yeah, yeah. Just people just reset and then it's like, come to. Yeah,
I would never do 3 hours in anything ever.
But yeah.
that's, yes. So, like, you reckon you could go to 100 songs?
So I've got what I've got here, 2020. This is last year. This is a 2023 set creator.
Jesus.
And that's these are the songs from albums that we can play. And then there's stuff that isn't on there that we haven't added in. But it's just like, we just do set lists every...
Using Google Sheets there?
Google Sheets. Yeah, so it'll be like Barcelona, up there, and then so we'll just drag in the poo-poo.
Collaborative set lists or driven by Stu?
Driven by anyone who wants to do it. Yeah. We don't repeat. We don't repeat really night to night. Especially, our thing is we don't repeat any song from the last, like, time we played in that certain city. If we were in, like...
Jesus.
Yeah. Fucking
San Francisco,
like, in 2015, and we play there in 2024. We check that, like, Stu gets on setlist.com, and it's like, what do we play? Can't play any of that.
Yeah.
Those songs.
Yeah, setlist.com.
Setlist.com. It's real.
Yeah.
It surprises us.
Could be very handy.
And there's heaps of, like, annotations and stuff there that are, like, very specific.
Yeah, especially
Joe made, you know, awesome call type thing or whatever. But yeah, so
that's incredible.
Yeah.
Mm. All right, let's this has been a lovely chat.
Yeah.
Let's close it out with the Eagles. I want you to this is to just go for broke.
Okay.
Do you want anything heavier?
Yeah, let's go insane. Like
because there is one that I use when I'm doing
the pedals now.
Oh yeah, I use this Angel Meteor one.
They're doing
music
shit.
Oh yeah, boys.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, you can do some fucking like
We're on YouTube here for anyone listening, going, and so we've got the theme song up on YouTube, and Tom's YouTube his algorithm is suggesting two live streams of the Wiggles just singing shit.
Yeah.
Because he's a new father.
Yeah, it suggests like a great father.
Yeah.
But they're not like
and standard father. Just Footy and the Wiggles.
Yes, one of them's doing 540 currently, what is watching it live, and the other one's two.
I thought I'd expect better numbers.
Well, that's the streaming time, numbers, you know.
At any time. That's where the money's at, Joe.
Yeah, how old's your child?
He is 17 months now.
Oh, okay. So you've got an adult on your hands.
Yeah, pretty much. Yeah. He's running around.
Yeah, good.
You've got to fucking childproof the whole house.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a whole thing.
All right, let's do Wes. Is this the one with birds of...
we're flying.
Oh, is it?
No, I'm just checking. It might be. I don't think it is. But
the song is so much better than that new version. Bring it back, please. Okay. So I think we're okay here.
Okay.
With the old version. Because we don't want birds
What was
Tokyo,
the new version?
Birds of Tokyo. What's the lead singer of Birds of Tokyo?
Ian Kenny.
And Carnival.
Oh, okay. Both great.
Ian Kenny.
Western Australian bands.
I think
bands.
His name's Ian Kenny. Yeah.
Yeah, West Australian bands. Like Eskimo Joe or Little Birdie.
Mammal?
Mammal.
Oh, yeah.
Are they...
Basil Zemplis is from there.
Yep. Fucking, you know.
Yep, good on
we
him.
We need to talk about him.
And mining.
And Tame Impala.
Tame Impala.
Nat 5.
What do they do?
In terms of like...
Music.
Yeah, that's true. They just, you know, fucking surf and whatnot, I guess.
Good on them.
Hang out.
Yeah. I went to an Eskimo Joe show last year and it was them playing back-to-back songs from the sea.
Mm-hmm.
Which came out when we were at high school.
We were in I was in year 12. It was a big one for
really?
Us.
Really? And then Black Fingernails Red Wine came out as well.
Oh, wait, sorry. Okay. Is that... That's a different album. I thought you were talking about Black Fingernails
there was,
Red Wine.
From the Sea had that... hello, hello. Oh,
yeah.
Remember that one?
Yeah.
Great and then, song. Honestly.
Yeah, no, they are. They're great. They're iconic.
I always just wonder how like someone can like write or like an artist can like write an incredible body of... songs or an incredible song for a long time and then all of a sudden just start writing real shit stuff.
Yeah, it's
and like complete disregard, like I get it, people grow and stuff.
I mean, that happened with Auntie Donna. We just haven't made a good sketch for about a decade now.
No.
Arguably.
No.
You've
not if you talk to my mum.
Yeah, did your mum enjoy it?
Oh, I'm going to get a photo with you later.
Yeah, great. I was going to say about, you know how there's, I forget who was talking about it, but like, when there's musicians who are 90 and they'll be in the 60s or whatever, they always, when they're making an album, they always think it's their greatest work.
Oh, totally.
And no one's like, this is the worst shit.
And they always like update their gear to like the most like high tech stuff, like head microphones and all that stuff.
Yeah, Bob Dylan, like everyone.
He's the exception, isn't he?
Is he still good?
I think so.
Yeah,
Neil
yeah,
Young's okay. kind of the exception as well.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Who's the most famous person who's been like, I'm a King Gizzard fan?
Fuck.
Was it Nicole Kidman wore Nicole a King Kidman Gizzard shirt the other day?
That was good. Yeah. Stephen King?
Jesus.
Oh, okay, yeah, yeah. yeah. That makes sense, though.
He emailed us.
He's like, hey, I made Shawshank Redemption.
It was like that. It was just, he was like, he's like, yeah, I love Rattlesnake. Regards, Steve.
that is my favorite Gizz song. Just
yeah. Thank you.
I love Rattlesnake.
Thank you, mate.
Yeah, I really like it.
Cheers.
Just gets you.
It just gets you G'd up.
Yeah, that's what I could say the grand final. Rattlesnake.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Totally. Totally.
Do you, could you play Footy Footy right now?
That's a lot of fun. Yeah. Yeah. Can you do the thing?
Tom Zaharu,
hi.
Clayton Oliver, Joey Walker,
Green Day or something.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, no, what? Yeah. Yeah, no, it's great. All right, we've teased for West Coast. Thank you for coming in. We've taken up enough. Yeah.
Shattering.
No, we can keep going.
Oh, it's up to you guys, you know.
Can you play? Can you actually? Can I just have for my phone? Can you do the
Yeah.
That's really cool. I've That's never had cool. that happen in my life where the musician.
Yeah, right.
Well, I remember it, at high school one time. Played Purple Haze.
Yeah, I think so.
And just riffed it.
Oh.
Yeah.
And it just dominated. In
I remember Woman by Wolfmother.
And usually, that was also usually, one of them. Yeah. Usually people who sung or performed at the assembly, usually us, was fucking awful.
Yeah,
awful. But then one day, Joey and Alex Braithwaite got up and just dominated.
Yes.
And everyone in the whole gym was like, what are we experiencing?
Yeah, this is good.
It was really sick.
Yeah, that's a cool memory to have.
That is it's a great memory. I forgot about that. You guys hit the I mean, you weren't trumpet men, were you?
No. I knew them.
I was a trumpet man as well.
Were you?
But I did bail before I did my last post.
Over right.
the like this.
Yeah. Did you do the last post?
No, I mean there was a version of me that wanted to.
Yeah, right.
I was in the Jimi Hendrix.
Yeah. I started when Haydos did, so Haydos got to do
Yeah.
We don't know who Haydos is.
Well, he's another West Coast fan that
He's a West Coast fan. Yeah, I actually stayed at his house in Castlemaine last night.
Yeah,
he lives in Castlemaine.
He does, yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah. So yeah.
Good times.
Great times.
Yeah, what was your ATAR?
Not as good as I'd hoped.
I wanted
to do real well.
What were your year 12 subjects?
Music.
I did music, I didn't do any maths.
Performance or group?
Same as
I did performance.
Yeah, can you still do Texas Flood?
Oh,
see, yeah. This guy remembers everything. Yeah, well.
There's a Stephen Ray Vaughan.
This is quite a cathartic experience. What did you get for music? Did you get 50?
No, I think I got some, that was my only good one. 42 or something.
Did you have to do like a
vote? I'm horrible at theory, as you can see.
Mm.
I'm better now, but back then not.
You shouldn't have done Under the Bridge.
I was feel based, yeah. I also fucked it up.
For.
Oh, did we do? I mean, I was did psych in year 11. Year 12 psych in year 11.
Yeah, nice.
So,
do you remember it with your six subjects
in VCE?
Yeah, and also if you're listening, you are not your ATAR score.
You are not your ATAR score. but yeah, I did fucking psychology. That was year 11 in 12, and then I did music. English, fucking geography.
Yeah, you did geography in year 12.
Yeah, yeah.
What
I
is
loved it.
What
Love
is
it still.
What is it? Geography in year 12.
Well, they tried a new format that year, and we got actually fucked over by the we couldn't. We were studied for a certain bunch of things, and then we all did the exam. Came out being like, we just got like right. angry at our teacher. Yeah. Yeah. She burst into tears.
Yeah,
really.
Yeah,
that happened to me with physics as well. There was a whole section that we just never covered.
Yeah, you're a smart man. So you didn't do maths, but you did physics.
So I did further maths, but I really love physics. Yeah, and they told me not to. They said, if you're not doing methods, you can't do physics.
But you did well.
I love it. I did okay.
Important point to mark. We all went to a public school. So yes,
as you all should.
Teachers forgetting to teach a large component of the curriculum is quite common. But no, I did drama, music. I did...
Two Englishes.
English.
Did you do English lit?
Yeah.
That makes sense too.
Sense and Sensibility, I think
Lantana.
I don't think Lantana. Then History, Russian Revolution.
I did that too.
Lenin and...
Yeah, all that stuff. That Soviet style football anthem. Yeah.
But that's the thing, is I was marked down for these subjects, but I actually learn a lot.
Totally.
And that's like...
It's because we are not our ATARs.
Yeah, no, exactly. I'm not. I'm actually not. All right, hit it.
All right, here's the West Coast.
Listen to that. West Coast Eagles.
You can do Eminem in 8 Mile. Fuck the beat, I'm out. I'll keep going.
Keep going. Fuck that shit. Anyway.
No, that's really good. Thank you, Joe, for coming in.
Yeah, cheers.
Do you want to plug your band?
Yeah,
Nah, it's all good.
Yeah,
it's all good.
A certain demo of person keeps asking for you guys to play the grand final.
Mm.
So I think you should. Yeah, I would love it too.
Oh, it's just you guys.
We're the only ones listening.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, no, I think it would be great. So, Michael Gudinski, if you're listening.
Oh, I mean, he's gone now.
Whoever's in check.
No, there's people batting for us. I just think that the barrier is actually just the band.
Yeah.
I'm keen.
I'll do it. I'll say I'm Cavs.
I could do it. Just by myself. I do what I did here.
Yeah.
What is it?
What is it? Sorry. Oh, another one. Actually.
On a stage.
Yeah.
On the MCG.
Hang on. No. Yeah. What was that child guitar prodigy? Was on her head Saturday all the time. Something.
Tommy Emmanuel.
No. I'm talking. He was like when we were kids. He was like a child, and he would go on her head Saturday. Something Camilleri.
Joe Camilleri?
Joe Camilleri is someone.
It's someone Camilleri. Nathan Cavalieri.
Cavalieri.
I think it's
he played for Collingwood, I think. Nathan Cavalieri, singer-songwriter.
There you go. What am I talking about?
Amazing.
Look how he's an infant.
Why are we watching Hey Hey now?
We're doing screen sharing, aren't we?
No, I'm not. But I can change it to that.
No. I mean, people need to see this. There we go.
Oh yeah.
He did the footy a bit, I think.
Yeah, but this is practice, Joe. Like you did that. You did this improv. This little boy had rehearsals.
Yeah, I know, but he's
hyper focused. That's his problem.
He's hyper focused. I wonder what his ATAR was.
Probably a 15 music.
Yeah, that's true.
He needs to get a bloody train, if you ask me. Get him on the tools.
It's called VCal.
I knew this would devolve into watching Hey Hey.
Yeah.
Yeah, and the audio might be fucked, so let's hope not, but...
Joey, thank you so much for coming in. We must hit up a Carlton-Melbourne game or a Gold Coast.
I really want to.
Yeah, you can. We'll absolutely go together.
Mm. Gold Coast versus Frio.
Oh, yeah, that'd be fun.
Well, awesome. How are we going to do that?
Yeah.
I think the AFL
the granny. Come on.
No, if the grand final was Frio versus Gold Coast, there would be some deaths at AFL House.
You know, like fucked. I mean, I was, to be honest, hoping we'd talk more about footy. I've read up on stats, but I actually had reminded when you were talking about how the Channel 7 commentary, it's, and like how that at the prelim or whatever, how it was just so wanting that Vic team to win, and it blah blah blah. Yes. I don't even know where the fuck I'm going with it, but
I'll tell you something. This year we have brought in a regular statistician.
Yeah, gotcha. Yeah,
right. From Canberra. No surprise there.
Are you doing Weez in like the AFL?
The podcast. Yes. I'm the head of the AFL now.
Yes, how you do. That's how you.
No, we've got their name is Oliver. They're in Canberra. They are going to do a regular stats for us on bias in commentary.
Huge. Mm. That is huge.
There was a little bit done last year. Brian Taylor in a game, he called. It was going for, who was it?
Collingwood.
Probably Collingwood. Usually Collingwood. And he was like, there was 8 positive things said about this team to 2 per quarter.
Yeah, yeah.
We're on it. Seriously. We're holding the bastards accountable.
You really might, like, there might be, I know it's definitely time for change, but you might kind of, you might get somewhere with this place.
We want you to be the commentator.
Can
on you? Guitar.
Yeah.
That's the change we want to see. Yeah. Joey, thank you for coming in. Thank you for bringing your guitar and your rock and roll skills.
Pleasure.
You can catch King Gizzard at the Corner Hotel this Saturday. I don't know when it's coming.
Two shows.
Yeah, but there's still tickets at the door.
It is sold out.
And they'll bring their rock and roll drums and guitars. Yeah.
Exactly.
Thanks, Joey.
Thanks, boys.